Alright, this video is going to go over public good examples. The trick here is to remember the definition for a public good. So we want to know if a good is rival and or excludable. So rival means that if one person consumes the good, it affects another person's ability to consume that good. And excludable means, are you able to exclude people from consuming the good or not? So we can test a bunch of different goods to see if they pass this public good example test or not. So for example, an apple. If I consume an apple, can anybody else consume it? Nah, that's pretty gross. The answer there is no, because it is rival. For public goods, we want them to be non-rival and non-excludable. So we can look at something like a radio station. So just imagine your favorite radio station, whether they play music or perhaps it's a talk radio station. Is that rival? If somebody's listening to it, does that mean somebody else can't listen to it? The answer to that is no. It's non-rival. As many people can listen as they want to. And is it excludable? Can you exclude people from listening to a radio station? The answer there, too, is no. It's non-excludable. So unless you're talking about Sirius or XM radio, it's non-excludable. Radio station is a public good. So now consider air. Is air rival? When I consume air, does that mean you can't consume air? No, non-rival. Excludable. Can you exclude people from air? Well, unless you push them underwater, the answer is no. So air may be an example of a public good. And in fact, you may be able to add clean air here. Unless you're in one of those really highly polluted cities, then you could consider clean air to be rival. But in most places around the world, clean air would be considered a public good. You may imagine TV stations that you can get via antenna. Those would be public goods. You could imagine green spaces or parks. As long as they don't have a fence around them and can restrict access, that would make them excludable. Those would be an example of a public good. You could imagine parks where you go hiking or camping. Those activities could be a form of public good in terms of recreational areas. You could imagine a lot of roads. Those would be examples of public goods. Just because I drive on it doesn't mean you can't. I mean, we do have traffic issues sometimes, but most of the time, as long as it's a private road. Now, if you had a toll road, that would be excludable and therefore not a public good. Finally, you can think of things like scenic views. Just because I look off of a mountainside and enjoy the view, does that mean other people can't do it? No. So that's pretty good. Sometimes you may think of things like fisheries or clean water. And the idea here is, can you exclude people from fishing? Generally not. But if somebody catches a fish, does that mean another person can catch that same fish? No, that makes it rival. In fact, this would be an example of a common good or a common resource. And same thing with clean water. If I decide to dump a bunch of waste in it, or if I consume it, it would be considered rival and therefore wouldn't be a public good. So here's some examples of public goods. Other examples are things like national defense. As long as you're within your country, you're going to be defended by them. When I'm defended, other people will also be. Websites like this one or Wikipedia are classic examples of public goods. So basically, you just got to do the test for public goods. Is the resource or good itself non-rival? If the answer is yes, we're halfway there. Okay, is it non-excludable? And if it answers positive for both of those things, you got a public good on your hands.